Hey guys, just a quick video on how I clean up classic digital watches. I just take a small bit of dish soap and this old nasty toothbrush, and I'll put a couple close-ups in here of what this looked like before I got started. But yeah, I just use this toothbrush and I try not to get the watch too wet because it will possibly get in, if it has a worn seal, could get in and actually ruin it. So I try to keep it fairly just damp, basically, while I scrub this dust out. Okay, after a few minutes of scrubbing, I just go ahead and I take my polishing cloth that I use and I just wipe it down to get all the remainder off of that, and I see if there's anything left. And if there's anything left, I'll go ahead and I'll go back and do another scrubbing. Now that we have it cleaned and dried, I'll go ahead and take my tiny screwdriver, my little jeweler's screwdriver, because this particular watch is a Timex Triathlon. I think the date on it is about 1992. And I go ahead and I remove the screw on back, and we're going to throw a battery in this and see if it works. And if you read the back, and I'll have to overlay a macro shot, but I mean, these are pretty simple to restore if they don't have issues, right? Most of them don't. Most of them that come across my desk do not have issues. They just need a good cleaning and a battery change. And if you read the back of this battery, I think it takes a 2016 battery. I'm sorry, there's my dyslexia kicking in. It takes a 1620 battery, and that back is on there pretty good, so we're gonna have to give that a pry. And I usually just take another jeweler screwdriver, this time the regular head, and then I pull that back, and there we go. This one, let's see if we can figure this out real quick. There's a tiny screw right here and right here, so and then we've got this contact that comes over the top to where that can slide in. So I think we're going to have to take those two screws out, slide that battery out, and slide a new one in. Okay, let's take our jeweler screwdriver and carefully take these out. This is probably the hardest part. Oops, we popped the whole movement out. Let's get that back in. On a side note, you see these buttons right here that come in from the side? They press these contacts. Like this one looks like it's a little bit off. All right, it's got some gunk on it. But they'll press these contacts in. So those have to line up. A lot of times when these buttons don't work, there's just some gunk in those contacts. And this one is actually keyed a little bit. There's a little keyway right there that needs to go into to get that back in. But you can see as we press those little contacts get touched. And there we go, we're all back in place. I think I'll speed this up because nobody likes to watch people turn screws, at least as they tell me in the comments. Actually, there's a third screw. Didn't see that one. So we'll pop that up. Try not to lose these tiny screws. There's one that flipped over. Let me grab my tweezers. Okay guys, I think we have everything back together. Now one thing you want to pay attention to, and I'm going to see if I can get a close-up picture of this so you guys can see what I'm seeing. It's going to be a little difficult. But what you want to do is you want to make sure all your contacts are back in line with these buttons, and you can press these and watch them press against the contacts of what I would call the movement. This one was bent up a little bit, and sorry, I wasn't on the record. I realized when I did it, and I just pushed it down with this, like pulled it back and pushed it down with this screwdriver so it would make good contact with that button, because otherwise you'd get this back together and that button wouldn't work. So let's go ahead and let's get the back on. Oh, and also one other thing before we put that back on, make sure this contact is up, because that will make contact with the back and along with this one and this one. So make sure those are in the proper position. Otherwise it may not work when when it comes back up. Those are just really little things like that that you need to look out for when you're messing with these digital watches. Now, it could be the battery corroded and put a bunch of corrosion in to the movement itself. That's a much bigger problem. That's going to be much, much harder to fix. But normally what you will encounter on these is these little problems like this, and you can get this thing running pretty easily. So we'll see if that's the case on this one. So again, we'll fast forward through all this screw turning, and then we'll see what it looks like. All right, we have a display. Those buttons feel good. Not sure what those do yet, but this is my mode button, so this is going to be a very important one. This one right here is my start and stop. So let's go to the chrono, and let's do a start. All right, that looks good. Now let's hold this in for a reset. All right, looks good. And let's go to timer. We could start this, I think. You know, maybe if I actually knew how to use the timer, which I don't. Oh, now I'm in set mode. So yeah, these buttons over here are working now. So let's, Monday, there we go. So let's go back to the modes here, timer, alarm, and then time. I think we're good. You know, we got good movement on our buttons. Now we can mess around and get this thing set and, you know, test everything out really well. This one obviously needs a new band. We are broken down here on this side, so I'm going to look for a new band, come across this, do a little more testing with this, and if I have to tweak any more buttons, I can tweak that. It looks like I still need to do a little cleaning, but this one could be on its way to getting sold. I haven't looked up any sold prices on this one yet. These digital watches, especially the older ones, usually go for, you know, I don't know, 20, 25 bucks, not a lot. So, hey, if you need batteries or whatever, check the link in the description. Lots of things down there to help you with this. Shows some of the tools we use. Be careful with these tweezers when you're holding those little screws. Those screws will fly off if you get into a little bit of a twist in that tweezer. So put something down, and maybe not a microfiber, but something a little flatter so you can see those screws real well. But anyway, that's what I do. Those are the tips I have. If you have some tips, leave them down in the description below or down in the comments below, and let's discuss them. Again, we'll do some macros of this like we end every video. And just show some up close so you guys can get the details. And that's all we have for today. Thanks for watching. On to the shots.